Welcome to PP Learning Solutions. Using this video, you are going to learn about Hadoop. Topics covered in this video are Big Data Challenges, What is Hadoop, Advantages of Hadoop, Introduction to Hadoop, Hadoop Core Components, Strengths of Hadoop, Ecosystem in Hadoop. Challenges with Big Data. Traditional Computation. In traditional computation, it is process bound. Meaning, you have small amount of data, complex algorithms, existing distributed systems. In the existing distributed systems, you have to explicitly handle the data flows. You have to write the programs of your own to make the flows. Challenges with storage systems. Traditional storage systems like SAN, storage area network, when you want to process huge amount of data, the data should be gathered into processor where it is a bottleneck to get all the data into one place. Combining data. To combine the process data is extremely challenging. What is Hadoop? Big data is a challenge which is faced by the industry. Hadoop is one of the solution which can solve the big data challenges. Hadoop is an open source framework which is developed by Java. It is free of cost. Hadoop is a distributed computing system where the storage and processing are distributed across multiple nodes in a cluster. Hadoop can process huge amount of data, terabytes, petabytes, exabytes, etc. Hadoop can run on commodity hardware. Meaning for commodity hardware is the hardware which is stacked, that means not used for a longer time because of the advanced systems. Latest technologies require high-end software systems. Those contains multiple GB of RAM, huge hard disk, and more processing power. The systems which were used for a couple of decades were not suffice for the latest requirements. These were discarded systems. Now those systems can be used as part of your Hadoop solution. That is called commodity hardware. Advantages of Hadoop. Partial failure support. When you are using tens of hundreds of systems, there is a fair possibility few systems will go down. When any of the systems are going down, Hadoop will mark those nodes as not running systems, but the whole cluster will not come down. Component recovery. Once any of the system is recovered, it can smoothly join to the cluster without any issues. Data recoverability. Data is stored in the distributed systems and replicated according to the configuration, which can be used for data recoverability. Consistency. When you got a data and process it multiple times, you can get the same results. There is a consistency in the system. Scalability. Hadoop supports linear scalability. Linear scalability means when you add more systems or more nodes to the cluster, the capacity of the cluster increases. That's called linear scalability. Introduction to Hadoop. Hadoop is developed based on two white papers published by Google. As we are aware, Google is a search engine company. They process huge amount of data for their search engine. In 2003, Google published a white paper named GFS, which is Google File System, to store the huge amount of data. In 2004, Google published another white paper called MapReduce, which can be used for distributed data processing. Hadoop was developed by Duff Cutting. The name Hadoop is a toy name of his son. Hadoop core components. HDFS. HDFS stands for Hadoop Distributed File System, which is a reliable file system for distributed files. MapReduce. MapReduce is a distributed processing system which can process huge amount of data. Strengths of Hadoop. Scalability. Linear scalability. As told earlier, in a cluster, when you add multiple nodes, the cluster capacity increases proportionately. It is called linear scalability. Schema. You can save everything in raw format. For example, if you take SQL tables, anything you want to store in the SQL table, first you have to define schema. In Hadoop, you need not to have a schema. You can store the data in HDFS in raw format. Data. More data and simple algorithm. In Hadoop, you have a huge amount of data and you write a simple algorithm to process the data. Instead of you bringing the data to process, you send the process where the data is located. Hadoop ecosystem. At the core of Hadoop, we got HDFS and MapReduce. Apart from that, Hive. Hive is similar to MapReduce, but it is based on SQL syntax. Hive is developed to help data engineers to process huge amounts of data. Pig is developed for scripting guys to process huge amount of data. HBase. HBase is another project from Apache, which can be used as a NoSQL solution in Hadoop. Scoop. Scoop stands for SQL plus Hadoop. Purpose of Scoop is to bring the SQL data into Hadoop. Mahout. Mahout is used for machine learning. Flume. Flume is a streaming data flows. Example, log data. Oozi. Oozi is a workflow scheduler system to manage Hadoop jobs. Avro. Avro is a data serialization framework based on JSON. To manage all these components configuration, we got something called ZooKeeper, which is a configuration manager for the Hadoop cluster. That's it, guys. Thanks for watching.